John chapter 12, amazingly that our evangelist John, the apostle John, he recorded that the first thing that took place was the anointing of Jesus.
所以在约翰福音书里面呢，约翰就很清楚的记录到耶稣一切的他进入圣城的开始的故事，就是他被恩膏的故事。就是耶稣被the time when Jesus was anointed that day.
So during that time, Jesus was at Bethany.
在那时候呢，耶稣就是在伯大尼
in the home of Lazarus.
就是在这个拉撒路的家里
Martha served.
就是她的妹妹马太
Martha served the food, served the people.
就是她的姐妹呢，就是马太煮食物来准备给那些来的客人。
Lazarus ate among them.
所以拉撒路呢，就是在他们的其中的座位上。
And then the Bible tells us Mary broke the alabaster jar.
所以在这里呢，就记录到说玛利亚。 她打破了这个香膏。She
broke a 12-ounce jar of expensive perfume.
所以这个玛利亚呢，她就打破了这个12-ounce重的这个香膏。This
12-ounce jar is about 327 grams.
所以这个重量呢，是差不多有300公克。So
for those who are in aromatherapy business, or love aromatherapy, you know that 327 grams of pure essential oil is not cheap. Huh?
所以在我们这里，如果你有做这个按摩这个香油的这个生意呢，你可以知道327克的这个油呢是很贵重的。And
for Mary, what she broke was not a normal perfume. This is the most expensive one called the nard.
所以玛利亚她打破这个鲜花膏的这香罐的里面的这个香膏呢，是它是不普通的，就是很贵重的一种香膏。In
fact, this nard was imported from India, and then it was brought to Jerusalem and all the other parts of the world because this was considered as a very expensive trade item.
所以这个香膏呢，是从印度呢。 然后带进去这个耶路撒冷城里面，所以它的价值不是很不菲的。That
is why it's so expensive that people only use it for special occasions.
就是因为这香膏是那么的贵重呢，所以往往人是用它来处理一些很特别、很贵重的节日。For
example, wedding.
尤其是在结婚的婚礼的时候
，they will use this nard, yeah.
所以在婚礼时候呢，他们就会用到这些香水。And
our dear Mary in the Bible here, she broke it and anointed Jesus' feet with it.
Yeah, 在这里呢，记录到呢，就是玛利亚把这个香花罐呢打破了，把这个香膏拿出来膏抹在耶稣的脚上。
And then she even used her hair to wipe Jesus' feet with the oil.
甚至呢，她用这个她的头发呢，把这个香膏涂抹在耶稣的脚上。The
house was filled with the fragrance.
所以在那时候呢，整间屋子呢都运用着这个香味。And
Judas Iscariot knew the value of this oil.
所以那个犹大呢，在那时候他知道这个整罐香膏的价值。So
he said this oil is worth a year's wages.
说到这整罐的香膏，它的价值呢，就是等于他们工作一年的薪水。And
he was trying to say there's a better use of this oil.
所以他建议说，这罐的香膏呢，倒不如用来做更好的这个用途。And
what did Jesus say? In verse 7.
所以在第七节耶稣怎么样回答呢?
He told him, leave her alone.
耶稣对他说,你不要理他。
She did this in preparation for my burial.
耶稣说呢,他所做,玛利亚所做的一切呢,都是为了要准备迎接我的葬礼。
This verse tells us that Jesus knows what is going to happen to him when he enters Jerusalem.
所以从这一节呢，我们也可以看到很清楚的，就是耶稣已经很明了将要发生的事情。当他进入这耶路撒冷城的时候，But
I want you to look at Mary.
那么我要你们看一看关于玛利亚。She
didn't know what was going to happen to Jesus.
所以玛利亚她根本就不知道耶稣将会面对任何的事情。You
can see that her sister Martha was busy serving.
所以你们可以看到她的
Lazarus busy eating.
那他的话的弟兄呢，拉撒路就是在忙碌的在吃饮喝。
But Mary, her focus was only on Jesus.
所以玛利亚呢，在那时候呢，她只是专注在耶稣基督。
Her devotion was to this man, this miracle man, who has raise my brother from the dead. Maria, 她的注重心就是在耶稣，因为耶稣已经把她的弟弟从死复活回来了。拉撒路是复活了，所以玛利亚她的整个心态、整个的那个注重心都是在耶稣。 So Jesus was only her ultimate devotion for Mary that day.
所以呢，对于玛利亚来说，她带着一个感恩的心，对耶稣基督已经把她的弟弟从死里复活呢。And
that is why we, as children of God, we can follow the example of Mary.
所以她的整个心态呢，都是专注在耶稣，所以我们也能够像玛利亚的这样子来学习。
Our focus should be on the ministry that we are doing to Jesus.
所以我们的侍奉呢，也是专注在耶稣基督。
Your personal ministry to Jesus, your quiet time, your prayer hours, your worship time, your personal devotion to Jesus.
就是在于你跟耶稣之间的关系，就是你有没有把你的这个晨祷呢，或者是赞美呢，或者是读经呢，专注在耶稣那里呢？
Your ministry for Jesus is not as important as your ministry to Jesus. 你的侍奉对上帝的国度不比你自己本身的侍奉对耶稣个人本人。 How do I say so and why do I say so? For example, ministry for Jesus would be like what? You serve the people, you serve the church, you serve in the kingdom of God. Amen? That's right, right? 我们对上帝的侍奉是什么呢？我们对上帝的侍奉就是我们来到教会，我们来侍奉教会，我们来侍奉各位的弟兄姐妹们，因为我们在上帝的国度里面，我们喜乐的来侍奉，对吗？
Amen. Hallelujah.
So this is the service and the ministry for God. But that shouldn't take away your ministry to God personally, which is your personal devotion time. 就是说 你来教会侍奉，不代表说你就可以放弃自己本身在家里跟上帝的那个时间。It means that the service that you are doing in church cannot replace the time, the hours spent with God in your own quiet time. It cannot replace.
是的，当你在教会侍奉的时候呢？ 跟你自己本身跟耶稣之间专注在与他的关系呢，是世人之间关系呢，是没有任何事情能够去代替的。
That is what Mary is showing us here. Martha was serving the people. Martha, Lazarus, all of them, they were serving. They were serving, and it's good because the people need to eat.
所以在这里带出呢，就是马大和拉撒路呢，他们都是很忙碌的在侍奉人，去招待人。
And it's important because Jesus needs to be served, right?
当然这是很重要的，因为在那时候耶稣在当中嘛，所以能侍奉。Does
it mean that this is not important? No, it is important.
是否说这不重要呢？不的，这是重要的，来去做侍奉。But
then, when you have the person of Christ right there with you, when you have the Holy Spirit speaking to you, then you have to minister to Him. You have to cultivate this devotional heart.
当圣灵临到你，还要就是跟你在一起，你跟主耶稣摩擦住有这个亲密的关系呢，这关键是很重要的。
So we are saying here, what I'm trying to say here is that Do not let any ministries to distract you from your own quiet time with God.
所以不管你是在任何的事工上做侍奉呢，都不能够去磨去你跟耶稣之间世人的关系。
So brothers and sisters, my encouragement to you this morning, keep your eyes on Jesus all the time.
所以弟兄姐妹们，在今天早上，我要邀请你们每一位，能够定睛你们的眼睛在我们的神的身上。
Guard your hearts against sin, temptation, and unbelief.
保守你们的心，远离一切的诱惑，不让我们跌入这个罪恶的诱惑，还有引诱的诱惑。
Be like Mary who broke the alabaster jar.
我们要像玛丽莲那样打破那个名贵的这个香膏。Don't
let the ministry for people distract you from the more important ministry that is your personal quiet time with God.
不要让别人的那种侍奉来去骚扰你，而是最重要是关键在于你跟耶稣之间所建立起的世人之间的这个时间。
And after you have done your quiet time, you don't need to brag about it, please.
所以当你已经跟耶稣建立了你个人之间的这个祷告啦，或者是经修的时候呢，不必要向别人夸耀。It
is your devotion to your Lord.
这是你跟主之间的经修的时间的关系。So
adopt this attitude of devotion that's shown in the life of Mary.
让我们来去允许，就好像玛利亚那样的这样的心态。 把耶稣放在我们生命中最重要的那一部位。
Jesus, when he came into Jerusalem, he rode on a donkey back.
所以当耶稣进入这个耶路撒冷城的时候呢，他是坐在驴子的背上。
He was basically declaring to the people what kind of king he's going to be.
他其实呢，就是在向群众宣告呢，其实他的身份是什么样的身份。
He was coming as the gentle and meek king.
他的进入呢，就是一位又温柔，又谦卑的一位君王。And
he rode on the back of a lowly beast of burden.
就是他带着一个很谦卑的这个心态呢，进入到这座城。He
rode on the back of the donkey.
就是他骑在一个不是那种很名贵的汽车，而是一只一匹驴子。
So the donkey is known as a beast of burden because it is used to carry luggages, burdens, you know, tracks and everything. So donkeys are known as beasts of burdens.
所以李举呢不是一个身份很高的一种动物呢，是不是一种很疲惫的，只是帮别帮帮人提重东西而已的一种动物。
So Jesus came not on the back of white, mighty war horse.
所以耶稣的进入呢，不是骑着一只很名贵的白马。
He didn't come on Galen's stallion. 他不是在很壮的马的后面过进来。 Yeah,
sorry.
So Jesus came as an image of peace.
耶稣是带着一种平安的仪式呢，进入到这城里。
Because when a king rides on a horse, it is a time for war.
所以当一位君王他骑着马的时候呢，就代表战争要
But when the king wants to make peace with another kingdom, he will go on a donkey's back.
所以当那个君王他要进入另外城里，他做就代表他是要跟那国家带出这个和平。
So you can see also the other thing is that this donkey didn't belong to Jesus. It was a borrowed donkey.
所以我们也看到驴子。 并不属于耶稣，而是从别人借来。So
this is not a purchased donkey. Jesus didn't buy it.
而且呢，这些驴呢，也不是耶稣买过来的。This
is not a sign of weakness, brothers and sisters. It's not.
这并不是代表软弱的一个动作。Because
this is to fulfill the prophecy in Zechariah.
这是一个要实现在撒迦利亚书所讲的预言。
Because in Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9, it fulfills that prophecy and also it also tells us that this king that comes during this time, he has control over his power.
所以撒迦利亚第九章第九节讲的就是耶稣他进入这个城里这个 来的来临呢，就是要带出他的这个胜利的。
So Jesus was a meek king.
耶稣是一位谦卑的君王。
Meekness means what? Power under control.
谦卑呢，就是代表那个人不用他的权势来去控制，而是带着谦卑的来去。
And then Jesus, he was the meekest of all kings.
所以耶稣呢，他就是一个最谦卑的一位君王。
So the people knows that he's coming and there's Hosanna, Hosanna, that they want him to save them.
而且众人都知道耶稣的来临呢，就是说 Hosanna 就是叫耶稣来拯救他们。
So can you see the image during that time in your mind's eyes?
所以你们在这时候能够想象中在那个所发生的情景吗？
Put yourself into the crowd in John chapter 12.
比如说，你是其中一位在约翰福音所记载的十二章里面的其中的一个群众。A
lot of noise.
在你周围有很多喧嚷的声音。A
lot of people.
很多人。It
was totally chaos.
就是真的是一种骚乱的一个情况。They
have been looking for the one who had risen Lazarus from the dead, but he was not there at first.
所以他们在寻找的就是那个使拉撒路复活的那一位人。So
then they heard that this man was coming.
但是当他们听到这位使拉撒路复活的人要进城来的时候呢，
So some of those pilgrims from afar, they said, who was he? Who was he?
所以从外地来的那些旅客呢，都问他是谁呢？这位是谁呢？
And some who knows the word, knows the religious laws, they were saying, could he be the Messiah?
所以很多都知道圣经里面有记载的那些有知识的人呢，他们会发问说，到底他是否是那位要来的先知，那位弥赛亚呢？
And then some even said, can he save us from the Romans' oppression?
甚至有些说他能够帮我们从罗马士兵那里拯救出来吗？
Can he set us free?
他能够使我们得到自由吗？
So they want this Messiah, they want this deliverer.
所以他们很欢迎，他们需要拥有这位弥赛亚，他们需要这位拯救者。
And everyone rush over there.
所以很多人呢，就冲向耶稣要经过的那个地方。
Who said this? The Bible tells us that in John chapter 12, verse 19.
是谁告诉我们这些呢？就是在约翰福音十二章十九节那里记载到了。It's
the Pharisees who said everyone has gone after him.
所以那些腓力士人呢，就是说，他们呢，那些众人都冲向要去见这位弥赛亚了。So
the Pharisees even recognized that this Jesus was different.
那些法利赛人呢，就说，哦，这位耶稣他是很不同的。So
when the people welcomed Jesus into the great city of David.
所以当那些人欢迎耶稣进入到这个大卫城的时候,
they expect a king, you know, a deliverer, right?
他们所期待的是一位王，就是一位救世主。
But then Jesus came crashing down all their expectations.
所以所发生一切呢，耶稣所成就、所发生的一切呢，就是把他们所期待的梦呢，都破碎了。
Can you see or not that the people expect a king? Jesus came as a servant.
他们所期待的是一位王，但是呢，他们所接纳到的是一位仆人。
They expected to be free from the Romans, but Jesus didn't come. Jesus came to die.
他们所应许的是因为能够拯救他们脱离这个罗马兵的这个统治的这个情形呢。可是现在呢，他的梦也破碎了，就是因为
I preached this before about when our preconceived notion is being challenged, there will be offenses.
所以我曾经跟你们分享过的这个信息，就是说，有时候我们所接受、所领受到的是会被挑战的。So
when you have an idea formed in your mind, and then this is not the reality, you might have offense against the person or the event.
所以在你思想中，你所期待的。 并不如你所期待中的实现的话呢，很有可能你会对那个人会有所忌视，会有所被受伤的感觉。That's
why when the crowd had this issue, you know, when they started saying, "Hey, this is not the Messiah that we were expecting. He didn't set us free at all."
所以那些群众在那时候呢，他们的感觉呢，就是有一种被出卖，就是说我所期待的是一位王，是一位救世主，但是他现在呢，来是要被钉死的。
And offense started to build up.
所以他们对于这个,
and then subsequently from this offense, it started to build into what? The unbelief of the people.
所以他们有这个抗拒呢, 就建立成了对这个不相信的这个意态。
So in John chapter 12, verse 37, you can see the reason why the people crucified Jesus was because of the unbelief in their hearts.
所以在约翰福音十二章二十七节讲的，所以就是因众他们的不信呢，他们就把耶稣钉在十字架。And
that is why the same crowd of people who welcomed Jesus into the city would be the same one to put him on that cross.
是同一种同样的这些群众呢，欢迎耶稣，也是同样的群众把耶稣钉在十字架。The
crowd that cries, "Hosanna, Hosanna!" was a crowd who cries, "Crucify him, crucify him."
这开始那些群众说 "Hosanna, Hosanna" 的时候呢，过后他们又以这个钉死他，钉死他。
This is the danger of offense if you are not careful.
这就是被得罪的这种的感觉的这种意念发生。
When you harbor, when you keep this offense in your heart, it can make you miss out the big picture of God in your life.
所以你好像被得罪了的那种感觉在你心底里面呢，那么你就失去了上帝带给你的祝福。That
was what happened to the people of Israel that time. They missed out that this was really the Messiah who was going to save them from the final battle of death.
所以那时候呢，那些群有些的群众呢，他们就失去了 最后呢，所耶稣所要带给他们的胜利。That's
why the Bible tells us in Proverbs, "Always guard your heart above all else. Guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it."
所以在这个箴言书讲的很清楚的，就是我们要保守的我们的心胜过一切。The
enemy knows this.
所以我们的敌人都很明了这些。The
devil knows this.
所以魔鬼呢，他也知道。
And the devil wants you to miss out from the big plan of God. in your life.
所以那位恶者呢，要我们远离上帝所匹配给我们的这个。
What is the easiest way to do so? Offense.
所以他们的计，他们的诡计呢，就是让你们能够领受到更多被得罪的那种意念。
For example, like gossips, slanders.
比如说讲是非。
For example, hurt.
比如说被受伤。
For example, illnesses.
比如说治病。
For example, you know, illnesses that can be seen or cannot be seen.
比如说看得到或者是看不到的治病。
And then, for example, things that you could see, cannot see, heard and unheard.
比如说某某东西你看得见或者是你看不见或者是你被受伤看不到的和看到的。
So this is what the enemy wants to do. He wants to take over your victory.
所以就是恶者要这样子的来去以这种方式来去攻击我们。
So don't let the enemy win, brothers and sisters.
我们不要让我们的敌人以这种方式来去攻击我们，来去蒙蔽我们。
Don't let yourself be like the crowd who miss out on the big plan of God.
让我们每一个人不要像在那些群众里的其中一位，有带着这样的心态。
You see, when the Pharisees said, there's nothing we can do, everyone has gone after him.
所以那法利赛人那时候说，我们不能够控制这些人群走向这位弥赛亚，不管我们有任何的方式来阻止他们。
It shows that the people during that time, they have this king in their heart.
这就代表说，在那时候呢，这些人在他们心目中早早已经有这个
The Pharisees were concerned about what? Position, their political position in the religious system of Jewish people.
所以这些法利赛人呢，他们所专注的就是关于他们的身份，他们的地位在那时候。
And what is politics? Winning the hearts of people, isn't it?
所以我们要讲的政治上的呢，就是关于他们要控制那些犹太人的心。
So when Jesus came into Jerusalem, they saw the people rushing out, Hosanna, Hosanna. They suddenly realized that Jesus has captured the hearts of the people.
所以当那法利赛人看到那些人群都冲向要寻找这位弥赛亚的时候呢，他们都已经知道这些群众呢，他们的心已经被这位救世主耶稣所
Has Jesus captured your heart today?
所以在今天耶稣已经占据了你的心吗?
Has Jesus become the king of your heart?
是否耶稣已经是成为你心中的王吗?
Has he won you?
他已经引起了你的心吗?
You see, you have to know that you can encounter Jesus as a person, but if let's say he is just a theory, that's not good enough.
其实呢,你自己本身能够真正感受到耶稣在你心中的地位,而不是以立足方式来去,外界的来去领受。
Because if let's say he is just a theoretical king,
比如说他只是这种描述中的一位王,
you will deal with him only logically, theoretically.
所以你只会用一种, 不实际的方式来去接触他。
Like for example, my husband just now, you know, she gave me a surprise, right? So, if let's say I only deal with my husband as a theoretically, he's a man, he's my husband.
比如说我对我的丈夫的监管就是他只是我的一位丈夫，他只是我跟我结婚的一个那个人。
I only deal with my relationship theoretically, logically.
就是说我与他的关系呢，就是一个实体上的而已。
And then we, the two of us, we will miss out on a lot of the wonderful relationship, the bliss of marriage, right?
比如说我没有关键到我跟我丈夫之间是我们是真正的夫妻，有这种夫妻之间的关系呢，那么那种甜美的，我们所拥有的那美好的时刻都不存在了。So
we have to see that one thing here. When we only deal with Jesus as just, you know, Jesus of the Bible, that's all. You know, I don't come to him every day. I don't come to him having a relationship. He's just my theoretical king.
比如说我们跟耶稣之间的关系呢，就只是看到所记载在圣经里面的那一位耶稣而已。那么我跟他根本就没有更深入的那种亲密的关系呢，那么那也是没有任何益处的。So
you can see that when this happens, right, we will not enjoy the wonderful relationship between my master and me.
所以呢，我们就会丧失了我们跟我们的主人们的这位耶稣基督的那种。 很深入的，很亲密的，能够明了对方的心意的关系了。So
in order for us to approach Jesus as the King of our hearts, we really need to trust Him with all our hearts.
比如说，我们要引起耶稣真正成为我们个人心中的王呢？那么，我们真的是要培养出跟他一种更深入、更亲密的那种感觉。
So when Jesus comes riding on a donkey, he is basically instituting his reign, his kingdom.
所以当耶稣骑着这个驴子进城来说呢，那时候的耶稣的心态呢，他已经带着一种战胜了一切的国度的精神来到这个城里。So
the king has come, but the kingdom has to come as well.
所以这位王来了，那么他的国度也是一样的会临到。
So when you encounter Jesus, when you welcome Jesus, you are encountering the King.
所以当你能够经历到耶稣的时候呢，意思就是说你已经经历到了这位王。
So like the Jewish people, when they welcomed Jesus into Jerusalem, they were encountering the King.
就好像那些犹太人，当他们接触到这位王的时候呢，他们也接触到了这位。
So you encounter your king when you say, yes, Jesus, I want to follow you. What is that? That is justification.
所以当你迎接到你这一王呢，就是这位耶稣呢，就是我们就是带出这个被成圣的这个在我们的生命中里。Justification
happens that time. Your sins are all pardoned.
所以就是说这个被成圣呢，justification是被称义。 在那时候呢，就是已经发生了。在那时候，Now
you are a Christian, but has the kingdom come into your life?
说呢，你已经是一位基督徒，那么神的国度有没有带进在你的生命中里面呢？
You need to encounter the reign of the king.
所以你必须要去经历到这位王。
You need to encounter the kingdom of this lowly and meek king.
你要去经历到这个王统治在你生命中里面，而且也去经历到这位谦卑的这个王这个的样式的生活。
This king that knows that he is going into his death, and yet he comes.
这位王知道他要面临死亡，但是还是选择进入这个城。
Where do you encounter this? How do you encounter this kingdom, this reign of the king in your life? How do you do that?
你怎么样能够面临到这位，能够引领到这个过渡的这个统治在你的生命里，你怎么样去迎娶到呢？
Where do you encounter this in your daily life?
就是你怎么样能够去经历到呢？就是在你每一天的，在你的生活里。
In your daily choices.
在你每一天在操作工作的方式上。
In your crisis when you are angry and mad.
在你面对危机，当你面对憎恨的时刻。
What decision will you make?
在那时候你要做怎么样，什么样的选择呢？
In a difficult moment, a valley experience,
在很困难，在有很多不同的领受的时候,
will you leave your king?
你会离开你这一位王吗?
This will tell you whether does the king rule your heart.
在那时候呢，你就能够领悟到到底这一王有没有真正在你的心中里面做王。
This is the process of sanctification.
这就是我们所讲的这个成圣的那个这个旅程。
Sanctification is what? Every day you become more and more like Christ.
这个成圣的这个旅程呢，就是我们每一天都改变得更像耶稣。
You let the principles and the person of Christ to change your decision, your way of thinking. It's a renewal of your mind.
就是我们让耶稣的样式，耶稣的形式，在我们生活中里面有所的改变。
So when you have the sanctification, when you allow the kingdom rule you, the kingdom reign, the king reign over you, then you know that you have the king in your heart.
当你面临到这个成圣的，一直被改变的时候的境界呢？ 你就知道你已经把耶稣当作是你生命中的那个王来去控制。
So, after that, you will have the eternal hope because you are going to see the King of Glory one day.
一直到呢，到了那一天，我们会到着这个荣耀的这个荣耀的那个阶段。
This King of Glory will welcome you.
所以那位荣耀的王将会在那一边，在上面来等待着我们。
And if you need assurance right now, this King of Glory can give you.
所以如果你渴望有这位荣耀的王的这个给你的启示呢？
So just like what happened during Palm Sunday, brothers and sisters,
就好像我们刚才所讲的这个中支的节日。
The Jewish people saw Jesus, welcomed Jesus.
这些犹太人，他们看到耶稣，他们欢迎他。
But they didn't allow the reign of Jesus to rule their heart.
但是他们并没有去接受这位王来管理他们的生命。
So this caused them to miss out the big plan of God.
就让他们失去了神在他们生命中所要实行的计划。